Hey guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
The Speaking Podcast is brought to you by our friends at Flemington Car and Truck Country. Best car buying experience ever online at Flemington.com. Award-winning House of Cupcakes, HouseofCupcakes.com, and Casa Gennaro's. Reservations, call 609-683-1212.
Hey guys, Bill Spadia here, back on the Speaking Podcast with my friends and co-hosts, Jessica Gibson and Jay Black. Welcome back, guys.
Hello, Bill.
Hi.
So I want to first point out, Jessica, as we started this, I noticed in the background of Jay's house, the ladder or shelf or whatever the hell that was behind the couch, either he's moved the camera or somebody cleaned it up.
I think it's still there.
It's still there. You can see a little triangle there. I did not move the camera. No, the camera's still in the same spot so far as I know.
Is that thing just migrating? Is it moving on its own?
Is like I Tetrised it all into like a smaller, less unstable pile. I spent the 2 days, my kids and my wife went to the Poconos to stay at my my in-laws' place, and I cleaned. So I this is the only room in the house that's dirty still, other than my kids' room. My wife just needs to go through it at some point.
Are your kids cleaning their rooms during the whole shutdown? Stay at home order.
We look like, if you've ever seen like one of those video games that take place in the post-apocalyptic world and you're like going through like the different stages and like finding clues, my kids' room look kind of like that. It honestly looks like the downfall of society.
I think Jessica's house is getting cleaner and more organized and orderly every time we talk.
Is that true, Jessica?
That's true.
I would like my house to be cleaner.
What's that?
I actually have books here. It looks like I read.
Yeah, I feel like most of those are like biographies of mid-level athletes. I feel like there's like the Vince Carter biographies in there. It's like, oh, okay, well, you know.
So far, no one has noticed in our New York audience the bobblehead that sits behind me every night on Chasing News.
Really? That one on top of the on air.
You see it?
Is that a Chris Christie bobblehead?
Yeah, no, it's Trump. And no one has noticed it yet. So the angle I take, I shoot off this side.
Right.
So you can only see a little bit. So I'm just waiting. It's been 2 weeks. No one's noticed yet.
You know, if that bobblehead ran, I'd vote for him over the real Trump.
See, I shouldn't have even brought it up. I tried to bring it up in a friendly way, Jay. All right, first of all, the whole trending, your movie, Psycho Yoga Instructor, trending on Twitter. You being back on social media, was it tough to deal with that? Was there any negatives like, my God, this is the worst psycho yoga movie I have ever seen in my life?
So, you know, I talked about this with my therapist at length because he couldn't believe me. He was like, you didn't really like read every single one and go into depth. Like, that does not sound like you. And I really didn't. I didn't read a lot of them. I glanced at the ones Brian sent me, but for the most part, I think I'm at a point now, and I honestly feel like whatever's left of my soul has calloused over when it comes to that, and I don't really care. I mean, here's the thing: from what I understand with what Brian said, a lot of people were upset that it wasn't psycho-y enough. Like the big complaint was, you're going to name something Psycho Yoga Instructor, I got to see some heavy duty murdering. And this was more of a slow burn kind of movie. But like, I didn't name it Psycho Yoga Instructor. I knew the movie that we wrote, and I knew that the people who were coming in looking for insanity are going to be disappointed. So it's kind of hard to get upset about that, you know?
But it was like a legit movie.
It was
a storyline. The characters are interesting. There was more depth than you'd get from your typical Hallmark movie. I mean, I think it was very good.
The people who like could see beyond, you know what it is? It's like if my nickname was Super Killer J, or like my nickname was like Hard Abs J, and like you met me, the only question you would have for the first half hour of the conversation is, how did you get the nickname Hard Abs? Like, that, it doesn't fit. And then you'd get to know me, and you'd like me or dislike me based on my personality. But the name not fitting is going to put some people off right off the bat. And I think that's where, if there was any problem at all, like I said before we started filming, if I've learned anything from this process, it's that if you name a movie Psycho Yoga Instructor, you better make that yoga instructor psycho. And that's what I'll be doing from this point forward.
I think you pulled that off. I really do. Now, it's what I want to know is, like, how do you get ratings back from that? Because it's still airing. It's still in their schedule.
Yeah, they have overnights, and then they have, like, I think they call it first night plus seven, where it's, like, the first week, all the DVRs and stuff. I know about 600,000 people watched that night.
That's pretty good.
It was good. Yeah, I was very pleased about that. And it'll probably climb to, you know, my guess is it'll double that, you know, when the weeks come out, the weeklies.
Right. So it is, Jessica, let me ask you, is there any, I've been getting suggestions on all the binge watching. There's a new, I don't know if it's Netflix or Amazon. It's called Upload or Uploaded. Have you heard of this?
No, but I've been looking for things to watch. So what's this one about?
It's called Upload. Wait, hold on. Let me look it up.
It's Uploaded. It's about putting your brain into a computer.
Did you watch it already?
I did.
I haven't seen it. Wait, is it already on? It's the first series, right?
Yeah, Upload. Amazon Prime, I think, right?
I have Prime.
All right. Yeah. So I have heard very good reviews of it. Have you seen it, Jay?
I haven't. My son came to me and said that he watched the first episode and it was scary.
The guy chooses between like becoming in virtual death or having them try to save his life. That's what I gathered from the trailer.
I go 100% virtual death. Put me right into the computer immediately.
Jay, I think you're already there. I think you're actually in a computer-generated reality right now.
Well, whoever is generating the reality is doing a pretty shitty job of it, Bill. I'll be honest with you. I feel like he could amp up the amount of flying I do.
Jessica, when are you back to work? Or out of the house back to work? What's that?
You mean back into the office? Probably next year.
Isn't that wild?
I bet. I'm kind of glad I don't need to go back to the office. The first thing I heard about like protesting in Philadelphia was like people have been rioting and looting inside of J. Crew, which is like my favorite store, and it's right in my office building. So I don't want to have to like go in and see all of the destruction that's been happening. Like, it would be sad.
Yeah, it is sad. I have to tell you, I like this this reality of taping the show at home. I mean, it's like literally it's a function of turning on the monitor and the lights, and that's it.
Yeah.
And the downtime.
You're an expert by now. You should be the one that's knowing if we can use the same link every week or not.
Right. You would think so, right? I have to say, though, you remember, like being in studio, there was so much downtime.
Mm-hmm.
The downtime at home is great. The problem is I'm drinking way too much coffee.
What kind of coffee? Do you drink black, Bill, or do you put in cream?
It depends. I like brown sugar and cream. I'm a little bit of a baby when it comes to coffee. I actually like heavy cream.
Is it because you make a whole pot at once instead of the Keurig?
Well, all right. So I love Café du Monde, right? The New Orleans brand. It's like, I think it's chicory. So it's really strong. Tastes way better than Starbucks. So, yeah, we have a percolator. A total old school percolator makes 12 cups.
Nice. I go pot of coffee. I can't stand Keurig.
I don't like Keurig either. I'm sick of it.
It's
agree.
Watery.
It
tastes watery.
You got to make the tiny cup.
Yeah. Whatever. Anytime I've had it, and I'm not against it for any kind of environmental reason. I'm against it because it tastes bad. We need to have.
You drink coffee?
Yeah, I'm a big coffee guy.
That's funny, Jessica. I was thinking the same thing. I'm a little surprised you drink coffee. I don't know why. I don't know. I kind of associate coffee with the whole addiction thing. And I'm like, he must not drink coffee.
No, you're not that caffeine.
You're not Mormon, right? You're just recovering addict. There's a difference.
I am in favor of chemicals. I just can't take all the fun ones.
You just choose your chemicals wisely.
Right. Now, I make a big pot of coffee every morning, and I drink it black until 9:30 because I'm doing intermittent fasting. And then at 9:30, I put cream in it.
I've never heard anyone say that before.
Well, because I do...
Wait, was that material, or are you really doing intermittent fasting?
I'm giving it...
so ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm trying intermittent fasting for the last month. You do 16 hours of not...
Stop it, Jay. Jessica, do you remember he went like 48 hours or 72 hours or something?
Yeah.
It's
16 hours off, eight hours on.
You literally, Jay, you came to my house and you had the equivalent of a last meal and then stopped eating for 3 days.
Yeah, that was a bad move on my part.
Never again?
Never again on that. But the intermittent fasting, I don't mind. I stop eating at 5:30 p.m. I start eating at 9:30 a.m. So, like, I wake up at 6. So I can't
5:30 have... early.
What's that?
5:30 is pretty early.
Well, you got to remember, I go to bed at 10.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I've been eating at, like, 9:30 at night.
Yeah, no, I'm done at 5:30. After this, as soon as I'm done with you guys, I'll eat my meal and go to bed.
What are you going to have?
I think my wife is cutting up rotisserie chicken from Costco.
Jessica, have you been cooking?
I have, and I think I might actually, since it's going to be so nice, go to a restaurant today.
Wow, how about that?
Open outside. I'm thinking about it.
Yeah, Philly, it's a totally different feel in Pennsylvania than here, than in Jersey. It just feels a lot more normal. Jersey's not quite normal yet. We're getting there.
There's some stuff at the grocery store. I finally don't have to, like, search for toilet paper anymore.
Right. I have discovered Wegman's home delivery.
Is it good?
$4.
Well, question about...
And I tip the kids. And it's not only good. I think they're selecting the best of what you're ordering. So if you're ordering any kind of produce, you get the best stuff. It's great. It comes within 2 hours. It's awesome. So instead of doing a list... and then having to fight in the parking lot, and then having to stand in line, and all the other bullshit you're dealing with at the store, I click, the list goes right in, and boom, in 2 hours it appears at our door.
You don't have like a long wait list on signing up for that? Because
it's hard.
On Amazon, yes. I think like on some of the different ones, whether, I don't know, it depends on who's running it, but for some reason Wegmans, I think Wegmans didn't have a rush because people have this perception that it's high end. And I think actually the quality is better than most of your supermarkets, but I got right in. I mean, I started 2 weeks ago. And I just
tried to look up Wegmans right now, see if I can get in.
Yeah, see if you can get in.
I'm going to the grocery store, so I have some place to go and something to do.
I don't know, Jessica. I am in bunker mode. I love it.
Just because you don't feel like leaving, though.
Now I don't. I mean, it's like just from my... I have not worn shoes in several days.
Did you go get a Peloton or anything interesting like that?
No, I have a bike. Because remember, I put a gym in, I guess, maybe 2 years ago because of my schedule was so insane. And there was only one 24-hour gym and it was like 20 minutes away. So I was getting up at 2:30 in the morning like a lunatic. So I was ready for this. You could say it almost appears like I was planning for this. I was ready. And then it hit.
I've been planning.
Wine.com delivers wine. And I haven't found a beer delivery yet, except for some local stores. But I feel like it's just more expensive.
It's hard in New Jersey.
Yeah, it is. What were we going to say, Jay? Did you get in?
Yeah, it looks like it will deliver. So I think I'm going to give it a try.
Jay, life-changing.
Yeah.
If I need outside, I'll walk around.
Yeah, I take walks and stay in the house. I'm A-okay. I'm good for another 10, 15 years of this.
Yeah, you're okay with this. I got back on the bike. I'm doing bike rides again. Like, it's I don't know. It's weird, though, because for I don't know how many years, I was lucky to get home for dinner once a week.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And now we're having dinner every night. It's great.
I do think that there's going to be, in all seriousness, some lasting sociological changes from all this. Just from the fact that, like, a lot of us have spent 4 months connecting with our family in a way that we might not have, you know, in the past. And I honestly think that there's going to be a lot of divorces out of this and a lot of people who are a lot closer together than when they started. You know, like,
so we should do a bet. Is it going to be more divorces or more babies?
I think it's going to be more babies, but a lot more interesting divorces. Like, I think it's going to be like,
divorce will be more entertaining.
You're right. It's so not going to be like amicable. Yeah.
Is that quarantine ex-wife?
Psycho quarantine ex-wife. Or two people that were about to get divorced and then the quarantine hits and they're going to spend 4 months together and the wife just decides, hey, you know what? Probably easier just to kill you.
I wonder if your better half has had any thoughts on that, Jay.
I am 100% positive my wife has looked at me while I'm sleeping and thought no one would miss him.
I just went to a house showing. It was right after all the real estate opened up. And we were like, oh, why are you selling? And he goes, my wife died.
Wow.
Oh, my God. All right, you're like, mom.
Now, like, this is real life Jay's, like, next psycho house killer story.
He didn't point at a room when he said it, did he? My wife died right in there.
Yeah, it was bad. He did. He was like,
really?
It was where? Really? When? It must have happened there. Oh my God. It was so awkward.
Was it COVID? Did he say?
He didn't go into detail, but I imagine it was in the house from the Google search after the fact.
Yeah, I guess they got to tell you, Bill, you don't care if someone dies in a house, right? That would not stop me.
I love it. Matter of fact, I think it's better as a buyer.
Yeah, you get a cheap.
It helps your negotiating.
Absolutely.
You just. I hope for a couple ghosts. I think ghosts are very good for driving that price down a little bit.
I would buy the Manson house if the price is right. I mean, I don't care.
Yeah, you know, clean it up. That's all. Come on.
With LA, yeah.
But there are people who won't buy a house if someone died in it, near it. Like, there are people who are very weird about stuff like that. I don't care.
Lunatics. Relax. As I've said many times, the souls of the deceased are not coming back to look at their old house. They've got the afterlife.
I you know what's interesting? You have said it many times, and I don't know why that's a recurring subject with you, but you have said that many times.
It's because there's so many people that believe that there are ghosts in the world that I feel like I have to set them straight. There's either one of two things that happens. If you believe in ghosts, you believe that the afterlife is boring. Because if there is an afterlife and I get to meet God and have all the answers delivered to me, I'm not going to care who moved into my house. Like, what you're implying is you die and it's just like, well, I guess we just sit around doing nothing for the next infinity years. I mean, what kind of sad afterlife is that?
Right now.
Was that?
This is it. This is purgatory. That's what this is.
Oh my God, is this what happened when I didn't take my communion? Is that why?
Your fault, Jay. This is your fault, you damn heathen.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Hey, it's a lot better off than I thought I'd be getting.
What is that? That's not beer. Is that some kind of a weird seltzer drink?
Aha, sparkling water. Aha.
Oh, that sounds
good. My wife, let me put this out. Not sponsored by Aha, but my wife got coffee-flavored black cherry coffee flavor with caffeine added. Seltzer water. Delicious. Aha.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the brand? Ah.
Aha. Like, ooh.
Aha.
Oh, who knew? Aha. Yeah.
See if they have it at Wegmans.
Yeah, maybe they have it at Wegmans, Bill. Order it.
I will let you know. What is it? A-H-A-H?
No, just A-H-A.
No.
Like the American homeowners.
You said that like I am a complete idiot that I wouldn't know that, but you're right.
Yeah.
They do. So... wait a minute, Jay. First of all, apparently the movie paid well because it's $3.79 each.
No, like for one.
All right, no, that's a 12-pack. All right,
a 12-pack. You think
I don't know what the fancy Aha shit that you're drinking? How do I know how much it costs?
You're selling them loose. What do you thought it was like craft beer?
I don't know. 12 cans for $3.79.
Yeah, it's not bad.
It's sparkling water, black cherry, and coffee.
Yes.
Sounds disgusting.
She got – no, listen to me. She got
it. For $3.79, I'm willing to try.
Give it a try, Bill. It's delicious, and it's got a little kick of caffeine.
I don't know. Now you've got me in. Now I'm looking like, what do I need? Do I need some meat?
Ooh, we should do a show devoted to your shopping list.
I should do a whole thing. I should roll a Facebook Live on my shopping list and get input from fans as to what to buy.
Just let other people build your whole cart for you.
You know, I'll tell you, it's actually been cheaper too, because I have a problem. As Jay has an addiction, I have an impulse addiction in the store. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Right? Like you're like, oh, I need this, I need that. You can't do that online because you're searching for it. So there's no shelf.
Right.
I ran into the grocery store for like one thing. So I didn't grab a cart, filled up my arms with like 5-10 different right. things. And then I got to the line and it was wrapped like all the way past the deli counter, like through the whole store. And I was like, I would have gotten a cart.
Right.
If I knew I had to like hold like every little thing. Like I did not expect to be standing there for so long, but yeah.
But that's the thing. So you spend 4 or 5 times what you intended on. So we're saving money because we're just buying what we need. That's we have like a Monday morning meeting. We sit outside on the deck and we do our shopping. It's great.
I got my car to drive to my aunt's.
Yes, it's in the calendar.
To fix her her air conditioning. And I had 3/4 of a tank. I realized the last time I filled up was mid-March when this whole thing happened. I've done 1/4 of a tank's worth of gas in the last 3 months. So I'm hopefully going to be able to, stretch that out. I'd like to go to the whole summer without having to fill my car up. That would be delightful.
I don't know, Jessica, you may agree with me. I think what you should do is pool some of that savings and hire like a cleaning service to handle that room.
It's not. So you keep thinking it's a matter of cleaning. It's a matter of throwing stuff out, Bill. You got to figure it out.
How have you not monetized this and been on eBay?
I would love to.
You can hire someone to do all of that, too. You can hire someone to go in and trash it or organize it or put it how you want it.
Right.
But here's the thing. I would like to throw all of it away. In my ideal world, we just don't even look at it. We just take it directly to the dump without looking at it. It's got to be sorted through. Now, I'm hoping my wife will be able to get to it now that school's over. But
well, ask her on our behalf, because it's been 3 weeks. I'm just saying.
It's been longer than that.
I really expected it to be gone by this point.
I did, too. I lost that bet.
Chris.
Yeah?
They want to know when you're going to get through all this stuff and we can get rid of all the stuff behind me. It's a big question on the podcast right now.
You're a full-time job, Jay.
Was it?
You're a full-time job.
But look, come here.
You know what? You know what, Chris? You're right. We feel for you. Jay is a full-time job. That I believe.
Between the kids, work, and Jay, it's like.
Yeah.
I am autonomous. You just leave me to myself. And
he does nothing.
I do nothing. No, wait a second. Hold on.
Well, I built a chair.
Garage.
Uh-huh.
And I cleaned everything except this room that needs to be sorted through. It's got to be sorted through.
In 19 years, that's what he's done. Good job, Jay.
I made 3 babies, I think.
You built a bench, right?
Was that? I built a chair.
You built a bench or a chair or some shit. I don't know.
A coffee table and a workstation.
All right, so we for a future episode, we may be revisited by Brett Caprioni, who is no longer a member of Vanderpump Rules on Bravo.
Deep dive. I can't believe he's gone.
That was a mess. I feel for him. That was, apparently it goes back to a post on social media from when he was 21. They went back 12 years.
And you knew he would one day be on a Bravo reality show and become like catapulted like that.
Right. So I think he'll bounce back. I think he'll be all right. Because they didn't really go after him. The other folks that got fired had a lot more negativity around him. So we'll see.
What's interesting about him is during the conversation, it was impossible to get him to be negative at all. And believe
me, I know.
I tried.
He got it all out of his system when he was 21.
Yeah. He got it out 10 years ago.
He purged it. Well, that's the thing. It's like, you know, I do wonder, and, you know, I believe very strongly in holding people accountable for their words. But on the other hand, we need a system on how to, like, get people rehabilitated or show that people change. Because if any...
Jay, don't you think you can say something when you're 21 if you're stupid and you say it and...
Well, that's what I'm saying. We need to figure out a way. Right? Like, in general, you don't want to go everything you say is okay up until the age of 25. But I do think that there is room for people to show that they've changed. If they took everything I said at 21 and wrote it down, I'd be canceled from everything. So okay. I do think we need to have a process by which we go, hey, the person you are at 31 isn't the person you are at 21.
There is a process. It's called drop social media. I have a new thing. I turned my iPhone off 7 o'clock on Friday night, and I don't turn it on again until Sunday at 7. 48 hours, phone's off.
Wow.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
We've been in a row now. It's liberating. Yeah. It's unbelievable. I love it. I'm becoming very earthy.
Yeah. Look at you. No shoes. No pants.
No pants. I enforce the pants rule.
Oh, okay.
We wear, you know.
I get the feeling.
Have some civilization.
Sandals and eating granola pretty soon, Bill.
All right. Well, I got to go back and tape.
Oh boy.
So, till next time, and I'll let you know about Brett and give me some ideas on how to title this one.
Title the Brett one?
No, this conversation we just had.
Oh, what do you call it? We'll talk about it. Bill's shopping list.
I think it's the how to take care of Jay during quarantine.
How to care and feed for your Jay. Here's the thing. I've noticed when my name is in the title, people are less likely to click on it. So I think Bill's
how to care and feed for your Jay. Oh, God. All right, guys. Hey, I want to thank Flemington Car and Truck Country for continuing to sponsor this conversation, the speaking podcast. We'll see you next week.
Bye.
Awesome. Thanks, guys. See you, Jessica. See you, Jay.
You guys later.
Bye.
The speaking podcast brought to you by our friends at House of Cupcakes, serving you in Princeton, East Brunswick, Clifton, and Saudi Arabia. The winner of Cupcake Wars offers 35 different flavors, perfect for a special occasion or just a sweet treat. Houseofcupcakes.com. The speaking podcast is brought to you by our friends at Flemington Car and Truck Country, 16 brands of cars and trucks. I'm a loyal customer buying my last two trucks there and can tell you no one beats the deals or offers better service. Visit Flemington.com. The speaking podcast brought to you by our friends at Casa Gennaro's on Route 27 in Kingston. Call 609-683-1212 for reservations. They're open for dinner every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Ask for my favorite special, the veal spadia. Best Italian food in Jersey.
Hey, guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.